Hi, and welcome to my channel Swift Programming Tutorials. In this video, I'm gonna show you an elegant way to generate arrays containing random integers in Swift. This solution will work in Swift 5 and Swift 4.2. Alright, let's dig in. I created a Swift Playground project called Random Int Array. So, my goal is to create an array that contains random integers. Why would we need a sophisticated solution for this seemingly simple issue? I could quickly put one together like this. Let numbers equals, and I just use some random numbers, 1, 3, that come to my mind, 7, I don't know, 2, 9. Now, this approach may work, but what if I need an array that holds, say, 100 or 1000 elements, which frequently occurs as a requirement in stress tests and even real programs. Actually, that's exactly what I needed earlier today as I was working on the update of my Udemy course called Algorithms and Data Structures in Swift 5. If you're interested in my course, check the link in the description. I offer the lowest price Udemy allows me to give you. Now, back to Xcode. So, we need an array and fill it with random numbers. How about creating a function? I'm gonna call it generateRandomNumbers. It takes an argument called size of type int. This gives the size of the returned array of random numbers. And as you'd expect, the returned type is an array of integers. First, we check if the size is valid. Guard size and should be a positive value. Else, I just return an empty array. I prefer this approach instead of throwing errors or returning nil. Alright. After this validation, I'm gonna create a variable. I call it result and make it equal to an array that contains only zeros. And I will use this initializer. It contains zeros and its length should be equal to the size parameter. Now we loop over the items of the array and replace each element with a random value. For index in, we start from 0 up to, but not including result.count. And for each element of the array, I'm gonna assign a random number. I'll use the intRandom method to generate random integers. So int.random, and we need to provide a range. The half open range operator restricts the generated values to fall in the range that runs from 0 to size, not including size. And finally, I return the result. Now let's test our solution. I create an array equals, and let's call our new function generate random numbers, and the size, let's make it 10. And I'm gonna print the array. Let's run our playground. And here's the generated output. If we run it again, we should get a different result. Let's test it. Yeah, it's totally different, and so on. Awesome, it looks good. Although it's working, we can simplify our implementation using functional programming. The array map method can be used to loop over the array and apply the same operation to each item. So let's rewrite our function using map. The validation stays and also the result, but I'm gonna remove this for in loop. Instead, I'm calling map to replace each number in the list with a random integer. Return result dot map, and let's use the closure. And I use the same method to generate the random numbers int random and provide the usual range from 0 up to, but not including size. To recap, the map method will run the same operation on each item. In this case, it will just provide the value which we generate using the int random method. Let's run our playground. Again, we get different numbers, different arrays each time we run it. But as you can see, this solution, as the previous one, might create arrays with redundant numbers. See, we've got here two ones, and if I run it again, let's see, we have two twos and two zeros, and so on. Sometimes that's not what you want. If you need a list of unique random numbers, that is, an array of integers that has no overlapping values, we need a different approach. So, I declare a new method called generateUniqueRandomNumbers. And it has the same parameter list as the previous function, so we need a size of type int, and it returns an array of integers. Also, here we need to validate the input, so size should be bigger than 0, else we return an empty array. But if size is valid, I create an array using the half open range operator from 0 up to, but not including size. The resulting array will contain consecutive values starting from 0 up to, but not including the value of size. And finally, I call the shuffled method to, well, shuffle the array. Dot shuffled. Okay, I have to correct this typo. It should be int with a capital I. And that's it. We're done. Let's test this solution as well. I'm gonna simply copy this code and let's call this unique numbers equals generate unique random numbers and print unique numbers. I will comment out this print here so that we only see the values generated by this new generate unique random numbers function. And let's run the playground. We shouldn't see any redundant values anymore. Not here. Let's run it again. It works nicely. I could increase the count and we get a huge array. It will probably fill the console. You can play around with it. Now, to make our solution even more professional, we can extract the functions to an array extension. So let's create a new source, and I need to reveal the navigator for that. And here in the sources folder, I create a new file. Let's call it array extension. And now let's create the extension. The extension needs to be public to allow Playground pages to use the functionality we expose from this file. Public extension array, and now I copy over the two methods, generate random numbers and generate unique random numbers. I declared them as static methods so that we can invoke it on the array. Array again should be capitalized. And the two methods are static. Now, these new features will only make sense to arrays that hold integers. We can introduce this restriction using a generic where clause. So the elements of this array should be of type int. Here, we instruct Swift to only make the generate random numbers and generate unique random numbers methods available to arrays of type int. And now we can use the two methods like this. Let random ints equals array dot generate random numbers, and I give it a size, and let's call the second one random, or rather unique random ints, and I will use the generate unique random numbers, and let's print both. Let's comment this out. And here's the result. As you can see, the first will produce a non-unique list of random integers. We can see two zeros here. Whereas the second one has unique non-overlapping numbers. So that's it for today. I've shown you three different solutions to creating arrays of random numbers. Press like if you enjoyed the video and subscribe if you haven't done so already. Take care.